loud.
Oh, because it's my PlayStation cam.
Why don't you use your mic?
Because it's broke.
How?
Man, it's broken. It be dangling off my ear. I gotta tape it.
All right, Larry, thank you. It is indeed time for a draft champions matchup and what is set to be a great draft champions matchup. In the booth, I'm Brandon Gunn with Charles
You guys
Davis,
hate to
and these guys
here.
Should have a huge impact.
No, I got to tape it back together.
Game. They're ready to roll. We're ready to roll. Let's roll.
I need some Bluetooth headphones.
I thought I got you a Bluetooth one. Who kicking?
I am, but it won't let me select. Come on,
me,
controller.
Me neither. What the heck?
What was wrong?
It won't let me pick my play.
Me neither.
Call timeout.
No. I can't even do that.
Yeah, it's okay. It's about to...
I'm kicking the ball.
And we are underway here in Draft Champions. Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. And a nice
man,
return.
How'd they catch him?
Here at the 30-yard line.
Because you can't... No, I'm just kidding. Because two guys were on. What you expect was going to happen. Can't make both of those up. That just pitiful.
They go play action here on first down. Backing up. And they get to Newton and take him down for the sack.
Damn, what about the
What you going to do when he comes for you? Yeah, because I was covering that one dude with my middle linebacker.
Well,
the
cover
guy
this.
That was going to...
Cover this right here, then.
Okay. He's going to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. He's going to rifle one deep left side.
Are you kidding?
Complete. A gain of 39 that time. A
Don't you dare call that same play
that
on
from a guy, as we know, who can really
I am
play.
Telling you as your nephew not call that
so
same play.
Ways. Sometimes
Thank
he just takes off and goes, just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. Surveying the field.
Out of the way!
They have to eat this one as down he goes. They get to him for a loss.
It's a loss of four.
And it brings up third down on the sand. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
And five in the secondary now for the Giants on third down. Here's Newton. And he's
Dang
got
it. Forgot about that guy.
Down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line.
There's
the
so many people to cover on this route.
I know.
He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching
Ooh,
him
you're supposed to hit stick him hard.
It's a game of five, and it'll be second down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback has to slide and find open space to throw.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, in that play, the expression something certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosis.
He didn't draft the tight end.
Hit as he throws there incomplete.
Nope.
It's a tried and true formula.
That's the main part. Come on, Uncle Kevin.
No, I don't. I can throw to any tight end.
That's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's
since being hurt. I drafted linemen.
Yeah. Yeah, I usually do that when I have everybody.
I'm talking about offensive line.
I usually draft defensive. Pass. They come out in the nickel on third and goal. You kick, I tackled the running back, and that dude tackled you.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In
come on,
case,
Gabe.
The left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Perfect.
And the 13-year man puts it through.
All right, it's just 3 points. My defense held up. Usually when you get down there, you score, so I'm pretty happy.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
Four wide receivers. Oh, you think you're going deep, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Say, oh, yeah, you're.
Oh, yeah.
Shift together here from the D line.
The eight.
There's Hoyer.
I do the ball.
Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end.
You held it too long. I know what you were looking at. Second down. You wait for that crossing route to get open.
Oh. You did know. Thank you. You noticed. Come on. Hurry up.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete.
Oh! I always got one guy to beat, and he's gone.
We always talk about having to read defenses.
I can never beat him.
Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football.
Without
a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you.
I see some red skins.
And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
The one thing about draft champions is you don't play in the actual stadium.
No.
I don't know why it's like that.
Going up top.
Let's go.
And that one results in 35 yards.
Usually hitting a deep post.
Dang. I'm lucky I drafted him.
Because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. But if you hit enough cross, because
he's pretty fast.
And curls, start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a change up in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the change up, and on that play, it worked for big yardage.
Dancing to his left. And no escaping this time.
Hoyer cannot. He can't scramble.
You're trash to me. Yeah, that's why I picked him. When I got to my quarterback round, no one there had speed. And you know I like scrambling quarterbacks. They're real helpful when you get out the pocket. But now, I have to be pushing down on R3. Okay, he threw the ball.
He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. And it'll bring up third down.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that at just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage.
I like this play.
That's exactly what happened there.
Why you got all your guys?
And incomplete is the screen there, unsuccessful.
Had to kick the field goal there.
Feels like a good defensive play, but I know it's really not. They had a chance to keep points off the board. Now they have a chance to kick a field goal by missing that shot.
Yeah, especially at this spot in the field. He's got to be upset he couldn't come up with that INT. So the Giants now are going to turn it over to their field goal unit.
No,
left hash, this from 48 yards.
Stop. lag. It won't let me move the aimer.
You better call timeout. Thank you.